You want to make sure that your valve is open to the calibrate position. There are markings on the bottom that indicate calibrate and treat position. We are now in the calibrate position. From there, you are able to prime your line and prime and get all of the air out of your system. So we're going to push and hold the prime button. As the fluid goes up, we want to make sure that there is no air bubbles coming through. The purpose of priming all of the lines is to make sure that the air is removed from the system so you get a proper calibration every time. Once you have noticed that all of the air is gone and you're not getting any air bubbles during the prime process, you can empty your calibration cylinder to the zero mark by pressing the empty button. We can now notice that the fluid is at the 0 mL mark. This is always where we want to start our calibration process. If you have it any lower, it's not going to measure properly on the grades on the calibration cylinder. We are now going to hit start test. Able to enter the amount collected in the calibration tube into the flashing box on the HMI screen. Today we have collected 920 mils. From there you hit the next button and it's going to give you the test results. So the amount collected in the test, the resulted target treating speed, which is 82.8%, and our target treating speed, which is 90%. From here, it gives us three options. We can either choose to escape the calibration process. So this would be utilized when you have an interruption or you've entered something wrong that you've realized now. You can use the resulted treating speed. So this is going to alter your target treating speed from 90 to 82.8 to compensate and ensure that the treatment is applied to the product correctly every time. Your third option is trying to reach the target treating speed. Typically, it takes 2 to 3 attempts to make sure that you hit your target treating speed appropriately with the calibration of your liquid treatment. Today, we're going to hit try to reach target treating speed. From here, it's going to prompt you to empty your calibration cylinder back to zero. Once you've reached the zero mark, as indicated on your calibration cylinder, you again hit start test. We've now hit the 1,000 milliliter mark, or just over 1,010. Hitting the next button. So our resulted treating speed is 90.9% and our target treating speed is 90%. From here, you can either choose again from one of the three options of escaping, using the resulted treating speed, or trying to reach the target treating speed. From here, I would utilize the resulted treating speed. It gives the option of moving your treating speed up just a little bit. From here, the screen is going to prompt you to empty your calibration cylinder. This is to ensure that you have no wastage of treatment stuck in your calibration cylinder during the treating process. We'll be right back. sure that it is completely out of the lines and back into the treating process that will go down to the boot. Also, you want to make sure that you have closed your valve to the treat position. That way your treatment won't go back up into the calibration cylinder. From here, you can press continue. This screen gives you the option of, or the opportunity rather, to double check your recipe. It's going to give you a chance to review your job name, what you're utilizing in pump one and pump two, the application rate, and the percentage of error, which is zero. You are now ready to save your parameters. From here, you can choose to save and start treating, save and return to job view, or escape without saving.